it's a big, big achievement to be opening up a center like this in a building, a project like this, in a neighborhood like this, in a city like this. It's a rare find in the world today to be empowering so many voices in the community, to be bridging the digital divide, to be making the creative arts a priority, and enabling so many people to connect to that. So I congratulate you all on that. It's been an honor for me as mayor, and serving with this council, and I'm joined by Councilor Ellen Woodsworth, Councilor Andrea Reimer, and Councilor Heather Deal are here from City Council. Welcome, and thanks for coming, and thanks for supporting us too at City Hall. And there's a lot of past councilors and mayors, and one person in particular is Jim Green, who was a real champion of this Woodward's project from the beginning. He was dogged and determined, and it has become a reality. These things tend to take much longer than a political cycle to happen, so we got to give credit to all those who came before on the political side and the community side who made W2 a reality. And in particular, Erwin and Magnus, the board, and all the volunteers, the people who have been working day and night for many, many weeks, many, many months now to make this happen. I think of two times over this past year and a half when W2 really was a pivotal force in the city. When the Olympics were here and W2 had the social media center here that had people from all over the world involved. It was broadcasting all kinds of opinions and different voices out to the world about what was happening here in Vancouver, which was refreshing and really important to be part of the whole dialogue around the Olympics and the giant event that took over our city for so much time. So a pivotal point in the growth and maturation of W2, and all of the action that's happened in Story over the last year plus. I mean, there's been so many incredible gatherings, so many people that W2 has brought together and given voice to. Amazing events that have happened here in the neighborhood, and I think that build up the capacity to actually do fantastic and incredible work here at the new space. So I wish you well for the future. There's a lot of big challenges that we face in this neighborhood, in our city, and on this planet, and there's no doubt in my mind that W2 can do a lot to bring voices to the table that need to be heard, and give our youth a voice, and give this neighborhood some real broadcast strength. And thanks to all of you for making it real. And good luck. Congratulations.
We're going to do a ceremonial ribbon cutting just back at the entrance of the cafe. A couple quick other thanks. I see Tracy Friesen here from the National Film Board.